Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Hey guys, welcome to Convos with Cream. You know the vibes. Oh my gosh, I can't believe it's here. Oh my gosh, I've been waiting so long to say this, you lot. Welcome to Convos with Cream. God is so good. I can't even stop smiling. It's so emotional. Ah, oh, it's been a lot. I came to the set. I was so blown away. Big up yourself, Elmo. Big up yourself, Jay. I'm not even going to lie. They blew me away. I'm so happy. Guys, let me know what you lot think of the set. Is it giving or is it giving? You lot don't even have to tell me because I know he's giving. Oh my gosh, right, yeah. Oh, I'm a bit nervous, but yeah, we are here. And I just want to say thank you to every single one of you who sent me messages, who called me. Your words of encouragement meant so much to me. You don't even understand, like literally, like I was blown away by the support. I didn't even know so much people was supporting me the way how you lot supported me. Do you know what I mean? Like, wow, I just can't even believe it. Like, yeah, it's been a journey. It's been a journey, but it's been long coming. It's God's divine timing, and I believe that now is the right time. Everything is for a season and a reason, yeah? And this is my season for me to be doing this. I know you lot have been seeing so much things going on the internet right now, pure viral moments and everything and whatever, whatever. But yeah, I'm going to get into that. I'm going to speak on why I left RTM. And I'm going to speak on, you know, where I want to go with Convos with Cream. And I hope that I get to give you lot an explanation, because I know that you, my supporters, deserve an explanation as to why I'm not on the couch anymore. First, I want to just start by saying, yeah, I love my time on RTM. I met some amazing guests. Big up you lot self, like big up you lot. I literally like... I just loved everybody that came on the show, to be fair, like, you know. And yeah, when we started it, we didn't even know where it was going to go, but all we knew is we wanted it to give people their flowers, and we knew that we wanted to give people a platform that nobody don't normally give a platform. Big up all of the people, them that came before us. Big up all of the newcomers. And just grow and elevate and show our transition and our growth on the show. Do you understand what I'm saying? We all had our story to tell when people's actually just watching us on the show grow. I believe that people, what they liked about the show was the dynamic between me and Spray. That we got along, but we had difference in opinions and difference in beliefs. Do you know what I mean? Hold on a second, let me just have a little drink. Differences in beliefs and differences in opinions, you know? And the little back and forth and the little banter, but it was always respectful, and you could always see that there was love there, and you could see that we was on the same team, because I'm big on team. And I know I was one of the realest members on the team. We built it from ground up, and we persevered, and we stayed consistent, and we didn't care about numbers, and we didn't care about likes. We just knew what we was going to do, and we just thought that from God is behind the message, it will go where it's supposed to go. And I feel like that kind of energy is what made the guests feel comfortable to sit down and open up to us, because they felt like it was a safe space for them to come and talk. So those are the things that I loved about being on the show. Yeah, so a big turning point for me in the show was the M Dot episode.
Oh, hold on. Wait. When was the last time you went to Jamaica?
When was the last time you was in Jamaica?
Do you know what's going on the streets of Jamaica? When was you there last?
You made a big claim. It matters. You made a big claim.
Because what you lot don't know is the fact that I went into hospital straight after that, because I had really bad blood pressure and I had to have my baby early. And at the end of the day, I ain't coming on no show to put my health at risk. Do you understand what I'm saying? And I don't need two men shouting at me, telling me about my background when I clearly know about my background. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I just felt like it was starting to get a bit too much. But with all of that, what happened after me having my baby and everything, and just thinking about, you know, like what, how much I put into the show, I was thinking whether I should come back or not, to be fair. And I spoke to my family about it, and you know, we was thinking about it. Sprayer called me and he was like, "Cream, when you coming back?" You know, like he was excited for me to come back and everything, and everybody was, you know, like respectful to me. So I actually thought to myself, do you know what, me, I gotta come back. Let me go back on the show and I'm gonna do what it does. Do you understand what I'm saying? And go back with my, you know, the vibes and all of this stuff. Do you get me? And when we went to the studio, first, before I came back to the show, we actually went studio and recorded Mind Games. And I went up there, me and Math, and we was talking about me coming back, and he was gassed about me coming, actually. Do you understand? And yeah, he was just saying about how happy he was for me to come back. He was actually throwing Chronic under the bus because Chronic is always late. Do you know what I mean? And he was saying like, "Cream, you're always on time. Come, be, hurry up and come back," and all of these things. Do you get what I mean? So I was just like, all right, I'm coming. Looked forward to it. When I came back, everything was good. I started to speak on certain things. I was talking on my things that were dear to me. I got emotional and I spoke on something about mums, you know, young mums, when I started to talk on that. And yeah, that was actually quite dear to me, actually. And when I was talking on autistic mums and things like that, what people don't know is my niece's daughter is autistic. And there was a lot behind why I was crying. That's why that day I actually got really emotional. And even things like that, I feel like I've not really got a safe space to really go in depth for you lot to know about those type of things, because I can't get to speak on them. Do you understand? I can get to touch on them, but I can't get to speak on them in depth. Because there's a lot more that I can that I have got to show. Do you understand what I mean? And there's a lot more things that I want to talk on in regards to being a female, being a mum, just being a woman. Do you understand what I'm saying? Struggles, highs, lows, everything. There's loads of things that I want to talk about. And I know how to speak to men as well. There's a lot of things that I want to talk to men about and get a bit deeper. Do you understand what I'm saying? So sometimes things need to be why-free. Do you understand what I'm saying? And that's what I want to be able to more get into. And when you're growing mentally, spiritually, physically, certain conversations no longer interest you. Do you understand what I'm saying? And certain conversations I can't sit through for hours and hours and hours because I don't have no place to talk on them, nor do I want to. So I feel like it's time for me to be on a platform where I can speak on the things that I want to talk on, that I'm passionate about, that I know that it will impact the people that I want to be able to be to impact. Do you understand what I mean? So yeah, things just started to go downhill in regards to that. I came back on the show, and then I noticed that there was a little narrative that was there creeping in that he started to put in there between me and Trina on the show. I never met Trina in my life. Never said a word about her. Never said anything negative about her. He knows this because I never spoke on her. He spoke on her. I don't know anything about her. Anything I do know about her is because he said it to me. So I didn't understand why every time I come to work, you kept saying that there was an issue between me and Trina. And the only issue could be is between you and Trina. Do you understand what I'm saying? I don't have a problem with Chronic. The only issue I have with Chronic is that he likes to talk for Spray too much. Do you understand what I'm saying? So therefore, when you feel like you're getting it because and you feel like it should be Spray, maybe you should just be quiet and let me address Spray. But if you keep on speaking for Spray, I'm going to have to address you. Nobody didn't trick me out of my position because it was time for me to leave that position. I need to be in a safe space where I can grow and elevate and show my best self. And I don't want to be in any space that's going to draw me out of character. I am a human being and I take full accountability for when I did come out of character. But that's not something that I want to do. It hasn't happened in a long time, and energy is real. And I believe that I was brought out of character because there were things that were said off the show that I'm not even going to really go into too much, because I don't think that it really needs to even be said. Just know I have receipts that I have never said anything. I've never had a problem with anybody. So I didn't understand why everything kept on coming at me. When we're on the show, we're the host. I'm actually the co-host, and we're meant to be highlighting the guest. So that's what we need to do. I don't understand why everybody keeps on highlighting Cream. There's been many of things that's happened with spray on the show and on other shows on the internet, and I've never addressed them on the show or gaslit him or tried to show him up on the show about that. I've asked him about things off camera and said, would you like to speak on it? And he said no, he's never heard a word. Guests have had things that they would not like to speak on, and I've never said a word. When they speak on things that could be possibly alleged or non-alleged, you never hear Cream say a word. I come in when I'm supposed to, and I say what I feel like I'm in my safe space to say. I've never once said that I'm right. I've never once said that I'm wrong. I've never once said I'm perfect, but I know I'm realer than most. And I was realer than most on that couch. And I was realer than most for 4 years. So that's why I took it personal that people weren't realer than most with me. Do you understand what I'm saying? You know me because we started it together.
Remember when we was starting it and we spoke about integrity and what we wanted to do with the show, we wanted to bring on. We didn't care about how much views they had, how much followers they had. We knew that we wanted to give flowers to the people that deserved the flowers. We wanted to give a voice to the people then, the same way how they didn't want to give us. Do you understand what I mean? Build your own table, do you get me? When they don't want to give you a seat at the table, make your own table.
Cream.
When you build your house on the right moral compass, the right values and stuff, your thing will be blessed. And you'll watch it. First they laugh, then they copy. And another is the truth. And another thing is, when they first see you doing what you're doing, they will always ignore, because they don't want people to recognize you. So they act like you're not there. But you are there. You don't watch that. You persevere. And then you see God's work.
When nobody was there for you, I encouraged you to build that show. When nobody gave you a voice, I told you, go on there and give yourself a voice. And nobody can't edit you. You can. But then you started to edit me. How did that go? I was there summer, spring, autumn, winter. The only time I took off was when I had my baby. No one can't tell me that I am not a real member on the team, that I don't stand on business. I've always stood on business. I'm a big woman. Even that I need to address. I don't feel no way about being a big woman. Do you understand what I'm saying? Life is a blessing. Embrace your life. Do you understand? I'm happy to be the age that I am, being able to do what I am. It's a testimony in itself that I even had my baby at the age that I did, with no risks up until the M.Dot episode. That's how deep it gets. Do you get me? The first episode when we started RTM, it wasn't just supposed to be me. But guess who showed up? Cream. Do you understand? When everybody was against you, guess who sat beside you? Cream. Do you understand what I'm saying? But when it was time for you to sit beside me and rep Cream, where was you? You wasn't there. You let the comment section and the YouTube, even though I don't care about comment section because I'm built strong. But let me tell you something. You made them run with a false narrative that wasn't real, because you know it wasn't real, because I never spoke on anybody and I never told you that I didn't like anybody off camera or on. And you know that. And every time I came to work, you never said a word until the camera started rolling and you started to paint a narrative. Do you understand what I'm saying? And you told me things off camera, what people had said about me, and you didn't say it on camera. So don't say that you're going to show everything if you know you're not going to show everything. Do you understand? So when you're on there saying people don't mind showing me, how do they not mind not them showing me? But when it was when you spoke on them and exposed certain things on them, they minded you showing it. Do you understand what I'm saying? So let's just be real. You know, I'm in no competition with nobody, and I actually wish everybody the best. You know, I just want to focus on convos with cream. Let me just take a sip, because I'm actually just going to shake off all of that. Do you understand? Fuck all of that, to be fair. I hope that I've said everything what everybody needs to hear in regarding that. But I just want to say, big up myself. Do you understand? Lord, God, me, Allah brought me Neil. I'm even breaking my nail. But you know what I'm saying? Like, toast to convos with cream. I hope that you lot can follow me on my journey. I'm going to be speaking to people that are passionate about their stories, people that are doing things in the community, people that are in the music industry. I've got some surprises coming. I've got some co-hosts coming. I've just got so much coming. Do you understand what I'm saying? And hopefully that, not even hopefully, this is going to be a platform where you are going to see more of me and you're going to know me. Do you understand? In depth. And you're going to see the things that I'm passionate about, things that make me laugh. I'm going to be bringing on people that are close to me, people that I've never met, people that I've always wanted to speak to, people that I want to highlight, people that I want to big up. Do you understand? I've got so much things happening with this show. And I just want you lot to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and let's get it cracking. Follow Convos with Cream on Instagram. Follow Convos with Cream on Twitter. And just follow me. You know the vibes. So with all that being said, I just want to wish everybody well on their journey. I want to wish everybody on the couch all the best. And God bless everybody. I genuinely want everybody to win. And I just want to focus on me. I don't want to carry any bad feelings. Where I'm going right now, I don't want to harvest no negativity. It's all about positive vibes over here. And that's where I'm going right now. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I just hope that everything that I've said, you know, we can just leave it from here and I can just do what I'm doing and everybody can do what they're doing. Do you understand? When God says yes, no one can say no. Ooh, God bless, no man curse. Adatma say, Convos with Cream. You'll be seeing so much more of me. I got so much coming. Big up you lot self. Big up my supporters one more time. You know the vibes. If I love you lot one more time, I can't get over it. Like literally, the boost you lot have given me is crazy, I swear. If you lot only know behind the scenes, Jay and Elmo know. Me a ball, me a sweat, me nail, yeah, everything. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's just real and I don't even care. I'm not even hiding it. Do you understand? It's actually been real. Elmo's laughing at me, but this is it. This is me. And you lot are actually going to see so much more of me because you lot have seen cream on there, but there's a lot more of me to see. Do you understand? And hopefully I can just give that to you. You know what I mean? And yeah, man, big up my set. Thank you, guys. I really, really love it. I appreciate it. Do you understand? Let me know in the comments what you lot think and everything. Do you know what I mean? And I love you lot. Yeah.